students that are sleeping in spaces that are not intended for such purposes, students who are sleeping in shelters, motels, hotels, or trailers, and students who are residing in other people's homes, those who we call doubled up, as long as it's a temporary arrangement. If it's long-term, it's not considered homelessness. Across the U.S., one out of every five homeless persons is a child under 18.
The fact that we find clustering of homeless students within the district provides an opportunity to concentrate support services.
While the graduation rates overall are low, it's extremely low when you look at it broken down by race. Meaningful relationships with Black adults and also Black community organizations was the main factor they attributed to their ability to actually graduate high school.
One of the biggest areas that I really tried to do a lot of education around is on that doubled up population. 90% of them are doubled up and don't realize that that allows them the protections of McKinney-Vento.
Obviously, due to COVID-19, that has presented several challenges. One of the biggest is being access to technology.
We have a lot of families who have come into homelessness that are brand new to homelessness because of what's happening with the economy. It's really important that our liaisons are just aware of that newness and that they know how to have those really hard conversations with families about how to seek support.
For all of us who have kids who were, you know, in LA County or grandkids or wherever, I mean, this is an issue that really does take the full community to support each other right now. And I just look forward to figuring out ways that we as a research community can support you as effectively as possible.